presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, backgrounds, foregrounds, and slide elements. What's the difference and when do you use what and why? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, why don't you join the over 10,000 others who've already subscribed and clicked on the bell icon for this channel? I've heard this asked a couple of times, and people have said, well, why would I do it that way? And what's the difference between those two things? So I thought that I'd take a few minutes and share that with you. So let's head over to my computer, and I'll talk all about backgrounds, foregrounds, and slide elements, and when you use each one and why. So here we are in ProPresenter, and I thought a great example of this would be to use basically my slides from a conference that I just went to. Here, let me show you this one, actually. I think this is going to be better because it doesn't have a timer on it. Okay, you see this? This is an example of a slide where I'm using both a background and a couple of slide elements to get my point across. Now, I'm going to talk about this later. If you've seen my tutorials, you're probably very familiar with what that's talking about. So what is each one of those things, and why did I use it like I did, and what is this, and why did I use that like I did? Okay, so when it comes to ProPresenter, it works on a series of layers. The things that you do on the slide layer do not necessarily affect what's going on the media layer immediately underneath it. So when you add a background is persistent until it's replaced or removed. So backgrounds tend to be kind of incidental to what's on the slide. So going back to my example here, if we select this one, this background here, that's incidental. I could just as easily use, let's see, this background. And that doesn't change the meaning of the slide. It just provides a little visual interest. You know, maybe it's a little darker, maybe I don't like that color scheme for what I'm trying to accomplish, but really it's incidental. Backgrounds are persistent, so when I click on this, then this background stays up, even though we've got this checkerboard pattern indicating there is no background on this. So backgrounds are persistent. So that's why you would use a background. But why would you use a foreground? Well, foregrounds are not persistent. They act just like slides themselves. So this Church Tech U logo here is a foreground. But as soon as I click on that same slide, if this was a background, it would be underneath. But it's not, because it's not persistent. In fact, there's nothing underneath. It's showing black because there's just nothing else showing underneath that. But if I were to click on this background again, notice that shows up right there. So that's why I would use a foreground. When the slide itself, it's got either a video or a still image, and that is the focus of that slide, then you would use a foreground. But there's something else that you can do. I can right click on it and go down to convert media action to slide element, and it will put it on the slides layer itself. Why would I do that? Well, for a still image, I can resize things. So going back to this one, let's right click and go to edit slide. And I've got this QR code. Well, notice that if I move it around, it is not a full screen element. So I can resize it, make it bigger or smaller, however it makes sense with the design that I'm trying to get. Same thing for the screen capture that I did here. I can make it bigger or smaller, whatever. And so that's one advantage to putting it on the slides layer itself, is I can change the size. On the media layer, I only have three options. I can stretch it. I can zoom in until one of the two dimensions butts up against the edge of the screen, or I can zoom in all the way until it fills the screen. But notice that this isn't like that, and this isn't like that. So I have more control here. So that's a nice little benefit. So why wouldn't I want to have foregrounds always? You know, if I was going back here, if this was a video, and I don't actually have text here, so this text box isn't doing anything. If this was a video, why wouldn't I want it to be on the slides layer? Well, the reason is, let me grab a foreground video here. I'm just going to drag that there. So it's got this little icon, which is a little picture there over a little square. Whereas back here, this icon is exactly the opposite. Same thing for right here. This is the icon for a background. This is the icon for a foreground. Those are different behaviors that are taking place on the media layer. When I dragged it up here, I wasn't putting it on the slide layer. I was basically just making a like a pointer to point to this one down here. So that's what that does. So since it's a foreground, it acts just like a slide, just by itself. But notice that I have transport controls. So see, I can, with this particular thing, I could go back 15 seconds, go forward 15 seconds, go 30 seconds from the end. This video isn't long enough to show you that. Or I could add a marker. I have all that control here right underneath the preview. So that's nice. Also notice that I can tell how long it's been playing and how much time is left. Also nice if the pastor's playing a clip from a movie or something, you know. It's nice to know when it's going to end. But let me right click and convert media action to slide element. That will put it on the slides layer itself. Now I'm going to, let me just clear that out just so that we're starting fresh, and I'm going to click on it exactly the same thing, and you'll notice that it's moving, but there's no indication here. So I've lost that. So that's why I wouldn't want to put this on the slides layer as a slide element. Right click, edit slide. So notice I do have the same ability that I had with these individual pictures up here with the video. So if I wanted it to be smaller, then I have that as the option, but I lose the transport controls. I lose the timeline kind of playback bar, and I can't tell how much time is left and how much time isn't. So that comes with a cost. So that's why I would not want to do this normally. Now, putting a video on the slides layer does have an advantage, and that is, if we go back into show mode here, let me start playing a background video, and then I will click on that slide, and notice that I've got both going at the same time. I'm playing two videos at once. Now, I don't know how much time is left on this. I can't pause it. I can't back it up. I can't do anything with it, but I can have one on top of the other. So that's another reason why you would want to do that. So that is why you would want to use a background, a foreground, or a slide element for different pieces of media during different times. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, which I've just re-recorded for ProPresenter 7.11. So go ahead and head over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. Give me your name and email address, and then I'll make a login for you for free so that you can take that class whenever you'd like. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.